Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'm sure the whole House will join me in joining the Prime Minister in condemning the shootings in Strasbourg and extending our sympathy to the families of those that have been killed or injured there. Mr. Speaker, I'm delighted to see the Prime Minister back in her place after a little journey. Having told the media this morning that she's made progress, can she now update the House on what changes she has secured to her deal?
Right, honourable gentlemen, I did travel to Europe yesterday and meet a number of heads of government and the Commission and the European Union Council. That's precisely because I had listened to concerns that were raised in this House and have taken those concerns to Europe. And no one that I met yesterday is in any doubt about the strength of the concern there is in this House on the issue of the duration of the backstop. But I'm interested that the right honourable gentleman wants to know what progress we have made, because actually the right honourable gentleman couldn't care less what I bring back from Brussels. He's being clear. Whatever comes back from Brussels, he's going to vote against it, because all he wants to do is to create chaos in our economy.
Speaker, nothing has changed. If she needed any clarification, Mr. Speaker, if she needed any clarification about the temporary nature of the backstop, she needn't have gone to Europe. She could have just asked her Attorney General, who said it endures indefinitely. As the Prime Minister may recall, when she left on her journey, we were about to start day four of a five-day debate on the deal. Yeah. Since the Prime Minister has not achieved any changes, either to the withdrawal agreement or the future partnership, can she now confirm that we will have the concluding days of debates and votes within the next 7 days before the House rises for the Christmas recess?
To the right honourable gentleman, I had discussions with a number of people yesterday and I have made some progress, but there is further... But of course there is an EU Council meeting, there are further discussions to be held. He asks about the meaningful vote. The meaningful vote has been deferred and the date of that vote will be announced in the normal way. The business motion will be agreed and discussed in the usual way. I'll tell members on the other side when we've had a meaningful vote. We had it in the referendum on 2016. And if he wants a meaningful date, I'll give him one. 29th of March 2019, when we leave the European Union.